the ones that I know that have resigned indicated that they had lost everything, didn't feel that it was worth them going back, taking fire from the looters and losing their lives in addition to everything else that they have already lost. It's bad. We're requesting out-of-state support. We're requesting all the help that we can get. It is bad.
We have so many people suffering. I will just tell you, it's heartbreaking. All of the relief workers that I have come across are in tears. And I'm talking about grown men crying. And this is a rough time. We are asking for as much federal resource as...
Booing coming from Metro police officers today. The scene from cell phone video at 3 this afternoon. Who they booing? Louisville Mayor Greg Fisher after he showed up to talk to the officers arriving for the night shift. The officers who were on the job during the protest time. But the video shows their reaction, not happy with the mayor, and most of them walking out. I talked to FOP President Ryan Nichols tonight, who says many on the force feel the mayor hasn't supported them in the past and isn't supporting them now.
We're in night 7 of a protest, and this is the first time that the mayor, who's the leader of our city and this police department, has given his officers the time of day to even come speak to them. They see that as a direct slap in their face.
He says they are suffering insults and assaults from people they are working to protect. They are worried for their families in this city. They are frustrated, and some of them...
There seems to be a lack of courage to call it what it is. It is not a protest. It is an attempted insurrection. This is not a protest or demonstration. It is not a call for justice, and it transcends either political party. These people are anarchists. Antifa and others, they have no platform, no end goal, and no core beliefs other than to create chaos and undermine many of our social institutions, including police. They are well organized, well funded, and have an endless supplies of tools of destruction, have advanced communication, use intelligence, have embedded leaders and medics, and use coordinated tactics for maximum effectiveness and destruction. You might think these characteristics I'm describing one of any of our military units in any of our branches of military because they apply equally to both, but I'm not. These folks are no less dangerous, and they must be stopped in the foothold of our city and in our county. These are not protesters, as indicated by the quotes from some of their leaders as they were ginning up the crowd at Cesar Chavez Park last night, such as, quote, "If you're here to be peaceful, then you should have left 3 hours ago," or, quote, "Put your phones in airplane mode because this revolution is not going to be on camera." There are two things that these people understand that will influence the outcome here in Sacramento: overwhelming opposing forces and consequences.
As far as I'm concerned, Blue Lives Matter is an equity issue. There have been police officers across this country that have been targeted because they wear the badge. Look no further than Dallas, where 5 police officers died. So Black Lives Matter, an organization who's in their D.C. branch, said Black Lives Matter means to fund the police. One of their presidents in New York said we will burn down the system. We all remember in 2015 the yelling of pigs in a blanket, fry them like bacon, at a Black Lives Matter rally. That speech is allowed, but Blue Lives Matter is not allowed. And I will stand at this podium and say Blue Lives Matter is an equity issue, and Goodyear needs to come out and acknowledge that.